Night one, historic. What did you think of Seattle?
Yeah, we just touched on it. I love the look. Those white jerseys look so nice. So I was really excited just to see this team finally get into a real game, right? Get on the ice. What this team has dealt with and what they're going to continue to deal with in this league is just like everybody else. You got to deal with some adversity, right? And there was some adversity. We didn't even know who was going to be playing in this game up until game time. You know, I'm sure those guys had a little bit more of a tip on that, but the game could have gone, it was 3-0. It could have turned south on them, but I liked the fact that Hextall's group went out and they fought back, right? And they did it by doing the ugly things, getting the greasy goals, going to the net, paying a price. Those are things that every team in the league needs to do, and they did it, and they got themselves and fought themselves right back into the game and made a heck of a game out of it. So was it a win? No. Was it a success? I think so. And, you know, now that's officially here, and we'll see how they do in game two.
And Mark Giordano, to go from wearing the C with the Calgary Flames, for him to be the first captain, in terms of character, it doesn't get better. We all know the impact Muhammad Ali made after his boxing career was over, one of the great humanitarians in the world. There was a time that Mark Giordano in the last few years won a Muhammad Ali Humanitarian Award. Ideally, you're choosing that type of citizen as your captain. Smart move by Seattle.
Yeah, they knew. I think as soon as we saw that Giordano was going to this team, that he was going to be the captain. I mean, he was going to be a leader in some sort, but you knew that's the guy, right? The way that he leads by example. He goes in there, and he's a strong voice. I mean, it's really tough. You're taking players that are coming from all different organizations, different roles. They're getting put into different roles now. You never know how it's going to mesh together, so you need that leadership group. And I thought that in this game, the way they battled back, I think the right things were probably said in between periods, and they knew that they had to come out and be better, and they were.
And on the other side of this, all the Vegas Golden Knights have done is win every year. They, 3 of the 4 years they've been in the league, they've gotten to the round of four. Just remarkable for them, this first outing. Max Pacioretty, two goals and almost a hatty. For a guy like him who's proven to be a consistent 30-goal scorer at stretches during his career, what did you think of his game?
I loved his season last year. I thought Max Pacioretty really just he got that scoring touch back. And you can see it right here. And I always refer to this, Tone, because it's what I saw firsthand. I did a shoot with him out in Vegas. And I just watched him shoot the puck from close angles. And he has this really unique release. So in this game here, you had Pacioretty getting his shot going, right? He had two goals in this game. And then Mark Stone was doing Mark Stone-type things. He does all the intangibles, picking off of passes, creating turnovers, going the other way with it, making a great pass on the goal as well. So their leaders led, and it's a good look because you had Pacioretty and Stone with great years last year. They're not the youngest of players anymore, so it's good to see now that they're starting on the right foot.